वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज एल के त्रिपाठी योर असिस्टेंट टीचर फ्रॉम एपीएम पब्लिक स्कूल। डियर चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट द न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 10 ऑफ हिस्ट्री। द टॉपिक इज न्यू पॉलिटिकल फॉर्मेशंस। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस चैप्टर, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू नो अबाउट द न्यू पॉलिटिकल फॉर्मेशंस इन द कंट्री। Let's get started. By the time when the Mughal power began to decline, the world around had also changed in terms of political atmosphere. Ideas of democracy, republic, liberty, fraternity had started to emerge along with the emergence of modern nation states. This is very true. Mughal power was the last power in India. After that, the people of country started to talk about the political atmosphere of the country, and they talked about the ideas of democracy, republic, liberty, fraternity, and other type of freedom they wanted for their own. This was the dream of the modern states of the country. Now nationalism was on the rise, and there was a clear departure from monarchy to democracy. If you had to choose between the two, that is between the earlier political order and the upcoming political order, where would you choose to live? Definitely, if we have to choose the political order to live in the past political order as compared to the modern political order, so without any reason we shall choose about the modern political order. Rest. The 18th century is characterized as a period of political and economic change and transformation in India and the world. In many parts of the world, old monarchies were breaking down, paving the way for the emergence of a political order. While the Ottoman and the Persian empires were struggling to survive, the old aristocratic order in Europe was dealt a blow by the French Revolution of 1789. In India, the Mughal imperial system witnessed a crisis. The Mughal Empire reached its zenith under the great Mughals, about whom we have read earlier. Mughal period was divided into two periods. One was the great Mughals and second was the later Mughals. So during the period of the great Mughals, the Mughal Empire reached its high level. However, towards the closing years of the 17th century, it was beset by a number of problems. Central authority rapidly weakened the many of the provinces, both old and new. Broke away, which reshaped the boundaries of the empire. The later Mughals, according to historians, the seeds of the crisis can be traced to the Mughal imperial system, with its emphasis on the powers of the emperor, reliance on powerful nobles, Mansabdars, who were given access to great resources, exploitative land revenue extraction, lack of a clear policy of succession, and the inability to fully secure the Northwest frontier. Actually, all of these had been major strength of the Mughal state in its early years under its powerful emperor. But after Aurangzeb's death in 1707, his successors, known as the later Mughals, were unable to hold the empire together. After death of Aurangzeb in 1707, the Mughals lost their powers and strength. After that, the successor of Aurangzeb could not maintain the strength of Mughal dynasty, and they are also known as the later Mughals, who were not able to maintain the strength of the empire. His sons Bahadur Shah, Muhammad Azam, and Khan Baksh were engaged in a war of succession. Bahadur Shah emerged victorious and ascended the throne in 1707. However, his reign was short-lived and he was succeeded by Jahandar Shah in 1712. Often all revenue, political and military administration came to be concentrated in the hands of a few nobles or Mansabdars, giving them extraordinary powers over the regions of the Mughal Empire. The three pillars of the Mughal state, land revenue, law and order, and military administration, quietly passed into the hands of powerful nobles. The Syed brothers, Hussein Ali and Abdullah, who held the posts of Wazir and Mir Bakshi, became quite powerful and were known as king market makers. They installed Farukh Siyar the Mughal emperor. However, the latter was murdered when he tried to assert his independence. After Farukh Siyar's death, Muhammad Shah, the nephew of Bahadur Shah, succeeded in getting rid of the Syed brothers. However, Muhammad Shah proved to be an ineffective ruler. In 1739, Nadir Shah's plunder of Delhi rang the death knell of the empire. He carried away enormous wealth, including the Kohinoor diamond and the peacock throne. Soon after, Shah Alam II was appointed the Mughal ruler. Around this time, the European trading companies also began occupying territories in India. The English East India Company had established forts at Bombay, Calcutta, and Madras. In order to curb the growing power of the English, Shah Alam II formed an alliance with Mir Qasim, the Nawab of Bengal, and Shuja-ud-Dawla, the Nawab of Awadh. They fought the Battle of Buxar against the English on 22nd October 1764. However, the battle resulted in the defeat of the Mughal alliance and the surrender of Diwani, or the right of revenue collection of Bihar, Bengal, and Odisha to the English. Therefore, the battle secured a stronger foothold for the English in the country, while delivering a blow to the prestige of the Mughal Empire. Bahadur Shah Zafar, the last Mughal ruler, supported the rebels who participated in the revolt of 1857. After the failure of the revolt, he was exiled to Rangoon, now Yangon, the present-day capital of Myanmar. Where he was he died in 1862. His sons were killed by the British, thus bringing an inglorious end to the legendary Mughal Empire. Reasons for the decline of the Mughal Empire. What was the reason? Aurangzeb is remembered as the last great Mughal emperor in medieval Indian history. He was a strict ruler and expanded the empire. He was also one of the wealthiest Mughal emperors. Yet, he was unable to hold together diverse sections of the population and involve them in the process of governance. His policy of annexation also proved futile while depleting the military and financial resources of the empire. Moreover, the Mansabdari system had lost its importance since the powers of the Mansabdars and Subedars went unchecked. The collection of revenue from the provinces became uneven as the center was unable to control the regularity of the process. Aurangzeb's strict political policies also angered the Sikhs, Rajputs, the Jats, and the Marathas, who rose in revolt and shattered the stability of the Mughal Empire. Inefficient successor of Aurangzeb, stagnation in intellectual and military spheres, and lack of advancement in military equipment further contributed to the decline of the empire. Regional powers, the Rajputs. Aurangzeb's death was the rise of many independent kingdoms in the Indian subcontinent. The Rajputs were one such ruling dynasty. Sawai Raja Jai Singh, 1681-1743 century of Amber is remembered as one of the prominent राजपूत रूलर्स. ही फाउंडेड जयपुर, वन ऑफ द फाइनेस्ट प्लान सिटीज ऑफ इंडिया एंड द कैपिटल ऑफ द प्रेजेंट स्टेट ऑफ राजस्थान. द सिटी ऑफ जयपुर इज बेस्ड ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ शिल्प शास्त्र और द इंडियन प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ वैदिक प्लानिंग. नो डाउट अबाउट दैट. दिस सिटी इज वेल फर्निश्ड, वेल डेकोरेटेड एंड ग्रेट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर एंड स्कल्पचर. हियर वी कैन फाइंड ऑल्सो मैनी ऑफ द स्टाइल ऑफ शास्त्र एंड द मास्टरी ऑफ आर्टिस्टिक कल्चर. आर्क्योलॉजिकल साइट, दिस इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ जयपुर इज फेमस इन ऑल ओवर द कंट्री. पीपल फ्रॉम द एंटायर वर्ल्ड कम हियर टू विजिट दिस सिटी. आमेर पैलेस इज देयर, शीश महल इज देयर, जयपुर फोर्ट इज देयर. डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ब्यूटिफुल साइट्स, टेम्पल्स एंड द होल सिटी इज डेकोरेटेड विथ पिंक कलर. दैट्स वाई जयपुर इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द पिंक सिटी ऑफ इंडिया. नेक्स्ट थिंग वी शैल डिस्कस इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो इन कमिंग टाइम. टिल देन डू योर वर्क. Thank you. Have a nice day.